Gwinnett, live from the arena at Gwinnett Center. It is the girls 5A championship in the state of Georgia. 32-0 McEachern, ranked second nationally, up against region rival Hillgrove, coming in at a record of 26-4. Good evening, those of you watching on GPB. Thanks for catching us, however you're catching us here tonight. John Nelson along with the coach, Sean Golden. Biggest thing here, neither team has won a state title. This is region rival, region 4-1 versus region 4, number 2.
Well, you're exactly right. McEachern got a chance to go undefeated, 31-0 right now. But Hillgrove, they're coming in here just happy to be in this situation. And it's going to be a kind of chance to be ugly tonight, but I think that it's going to be a good game. Both teams are just excited about an opportunity. People, you got a chance to witness history and at the same time possibly see 9 Division I prospects on the floor at the same time.
All right, let's check the road twos and how they got to this moment in time. Let's start off with McEachern. First round, a win of 48, second round, a win of 43, then a win of 37, then squeaking past Norcross in the semifinals. Next page is how Hillgrove got here. Out of region 4, team number 2, winner over Windsor Forest by 21, squeaking past Stevenson, a perennial power, beating North Cobb by 24, and then beating North Gwinnett. They were down 9 at one point, coming back to win 56-51 last night here at the arena at Gwinnett Center. Now, when it comes to these teams and these particular players, we got to start with McEachern, and it starts with one name in particular.
Well, you're exactly right, Patches Roberts. This young lady is very exciting, going to Syracuse University. She plays well with the basketball, scores inside and out, shoots the 3 deep, and I tell you, she's going to put some points up tonight. Why, she could get 20.
Now, last year, McEachern, they came here, they lost. Head coach Phyllis Arthur says that the mood is a lot looser this time around. But when it comes to Hillgrove, once again, they're playing with house money just as much. And the focus here is on someone who hits her free throws.
Well, I tell you what, this young lady, really, she can really do a good job of playing basketball and shooting the basketball. She's going to Wake Forest University. And they love her because she plays well with the basketball, putting the ball in her hands, carrying the team on her back. And Rodrigo is really going to be, it's going to be important for her to really do well tonight.
We're going to see what Rodrigo does. That is the setup for this particular ball game. When we come back to the arena at Gwinnett Center, it is the girls 5A title. Somebody's getting it for the first time. Is it Hillgrove or McEachern? We'll have the answer when we come back right here on the great GPB. Stay with us. Welcome back to the arena at Gwinnett Center. Girls 5A title game just around the corner. Third member of our broadcast team is Lindsay Theory. Lindsay, what you got?
Hey, thanks, Sean. All right, well, Sean already mentioned how much D1 talent is on the floor tonight. And would you believe one of those D1 commits is only a freshman? Yes, McEachern's Taya Cooper, number 2. Keep an eye on her. She committed to North Carolina before even playing one high school game. What do you think, Sean? Will she do something tonight?
She's going to do something, Lindsay. You're exactly right. Do something. That's going to be the key statement for tonight.
Here's your McEachern starters, Cooper and Cooper, Taya and Mia. Dominique Wilson, also the third guard in that lineup. Patches Roberts heading to Syracuse. Destiny Gibbs is the fourth guard in the lineup. For Hillgrove, out of region 4, the number 2 seed. You're going to have a lineup that is going to have Maisie Steed at one forward, Meredith Hare at the other forward. In the middle, it's Mackenzie Ingram. Keep an eye on her. She's only a sophomore. Look at all the youth on that lineup. Selena Rodrigo, the player we focused on in the open, 23, and Marissa Lester finishes out your backcourt. Let's take a look at Phyllis Arthur. Once again, Phyllis Arthur, 32-0, coming into this ball game. They're nationally ranked 2nd in the country. They feel as a team a lot looser now than they did in the semifinals going up against Norcross. So in a way, they feel like they have nothing to lose even though they're way up the ladder.
But John, you're exactly right. Last night's contest versus Norcross, you think that was a state championship game. Going against Norcross, they came out a lot more intense. And I tell you what, they're going to bring that same intensity today because they're hungry to get that title.
There's Cheryl Fowler right in the middle of the huddle for Hillgrove. Hillgrove, this is her last game as a head coach in the state of Georgia. She has ties to McEachern, coaching there 16 years before coaching the Hillgrove program and bringing them into this position right now. Let's take a look at our referees for the game. Roy Lee Honeycutt, a very busy Amy Toady, has been busy down in Macon with the single-A games in the semis, and Eric Terrain is your third official. We will continue to update you on the Cheryl Fowler story as the night goes along. Now, the 3 games that these two teams have played, they've been one of 2 ways. It's a game that could make you drowsy, or it could be a close shave one way or the other, or it's a game that has been a complete blowout. Which one are you expecting here tonight?
I tell you what, it has a chance to be a blowout, but I think Coach Fowler and Hillgrove, they're going to come out here and try to control the tempo, and I think they're trying to do that early, but McEachern's going to try to apply the pressure, force it, get up and down the court, and put some points on the board.
tempo, turnovers, and taking care of the ball. That's the way it's got to be for Hillgrove. Those games, Hillgrove lost 77-40 January 13th. February 7th, it was a 43-37 game. And then in the region finals, it determined region seed 1 and region seed 2, 63-37. So you're talking 37-6 and 26. And the ball is up in the 5A title game. McEachern wins the toss. Working perimeter. Thinking about a long three is good. Off the bat by Mia Cooper.
See McEachern coming out attacking, hitting the three, going straight to the press.
Pull up jumper in the paint, rimming out, no good. Rebound fought for, and where's it going? It's going toward McEachern. The miss that time by Maisie Steve.
McEachern's just really, really aggressive right now. Shooting the three, getting into the press. They want to get an early lead quick.
Working up the floor, it's Taya Cooper. Lindsay mentioned her in the open. Destiny Gibbs now with the basketball. Near corner, spin move, looking to go into the paint, dish. Think of the three, pull up, jumper, good.
Two possessions, two baskets.
5-0 McEachern, 45 seconds in over Hillgrove. They are pressing on a 2-2 full court. Now they're releasing back in, but way inside is Steed, looking for the pass. They're going to kick it back outside and reset. Jumper on the board, off by Meredith Heyer. Rebound by Mia Cooper. Cooper to Destiny Gibbs. Taya Cooper thinks of the three, takes the three long distance, misses everything out of bounds, and it's going over to Hillgrove.
It looks like Hillgrove's trying to be aggressive as well, too. They're coming out, they're attacking, shooting the quick shots, but they don't want to play like that. You got to do a better job of controlling tempo.
Meredith Heyer on the inbounds pass. And two McEachern players trying to surround the basketball. And we're going to have a foul call. Looks like it's going to be called on Dominique Wilson, her first of the ball game, minute 13 in. 3. Once again, you're starting fives for McEachern. Taya Cooper, 2. Mia Cooper, 3. Dominique Wilson, 12. Patches Roberts, 23. Destiny Gibbs, 34. For Hillgrove. On the inside, thinking about the basket on the baseline, kick it back out for a three-point attempt off the rim, off the backboard, no good. People waiting around for it, picked up by McEachern on the inline, stays with Hillgrove.
McEachern coming out with a 1-3-1, trying to trap the ball in half court and force the tempo even in the half court now, and Hillgrove's just got to capitalize on some open opportunities.
Looking to inbound, Meredith Heyer, having to go long all the way back to backcourt to Selena Rodrigo. Rodrigo will take her time, bringing it up, down 5-0 here in the 5A title game. Once again, 13, Maisie Steed, 21, Mackenzie Ingram, a sophomore, Meredith Heyer, 22, Rodrigo, 23, and Marissa Lester, 24. Pass in the inside, knocked away, picked back up by Hillgrove. Thinking about it, once again, Rodrigo with the easy move, off the backboard, no good. McEachern players fighting for it. Looks like it's going to stay with Hillgrove again.
Rodrigo's doing a good job getting in there. She's got to hit those shots. I think as the game goes on, she'll be comfortable and knock a few of those down.
Heading to Wake Forest to play her collegiate career. Has the ball back outside top of the circle. Nice pass inside to Steed. Steed tries to throw it off the window. No good. Rebound picked up by Destiny Gibbs. She'll bring it across. And the give to Cooper. Mia to Taya. Taya inside to Gibbs. Gibbs turnaround move. Misses everything. The ball goes out of bounds, stays with McEachern.
It's interesting. McEachern really doesn't have a strong post presence out there on the floor right now. They got a bunch of guards and forwards. They want to play outside in, spread out, shoot the three and penetrate.
Pass knocked away, picked up in transition. Rodrigo with the bounce pass, looking for Lester. Picked back up in the corner. Easy one-touch passing. Passing too quickly. Cooper comes back with it in transition for McEachern. Top of the key, easy jumper. Good.
Pick your poison. You stop transition, but you still got to come out and defend them. They're going to shoot that three. That's what they want to do. Live and die behind the arc.
Dominique Wilson with the two makes it 7-0 McEachern. Missed by Hillgrove. And back comes Destiny Gibbs for McEachern. Seven in a row to start in the first 2:45 and counting. Now make it 9.
Got to be a timeout coming up real soon. There we go. Can't let this lead get out of control this early.
30-second timeout for the Crimson and Silver, down 9-0 after the first 2 minutes and 53 seconds. Obviously, the start that you're looking for if you're Phyllis Arthur compared to what happened here last year?
Well, I think that's what she wanted to do, set the tempo with their defense and offense, be aggressive in attacking and scoring, be aggressive also in defending the basketball.
McEachern, four of their first six on the floor. Hillgrove is 0 for their first six. Down 9-0 once again, 5:07 to go here in the girls 5A championship. Battle of Region 4, number one, and Region 4, number two. Let's look at the run from McEachern, and it has been from all around.
I tell you what, again, shooting the three. There it is, deep ball. That's what we want to do, live it by. Transition basketball, when you stop and help, they're going to spread you out. Again, bam, deep from the outside.
And then, of course, there's your inside bucket right there to make it 9. Back to live action now. Hillgrove with the basketball, trying to drive in. Shot is blocked by Mia Cooper. Gibbs coming back out with it in transition. Taya Cooper fighting for it, going into the paint. The toss to Patches Roberts up and in.
A freshman penetrating, kicking it out there. I'll tell you what, that young girl's going to do a good job up there in Chapel Hill.
11-0 now, 4:42 to go. Ball knocked out of bounds by Mia Cooper.
Here's that press again. They're pressing. McEachern forcing the tempo. Let's press. Let's get the turnovers. Get easy baskets.
Diamond Thomas now in the ball game for Hillgrove. Cheryl Fowler trying to come up with some kind of combination that'll put points on the board. Tiffany Schick with the basketball. Kicks it back outside to Selena Rodrigo, guarded by Cooper. Backcourt now is Diamond Thomas and Rodrigo. Pass over to Meredith Heyer, looking inside to Schick. Back out, top of the key, working the triangle near side. Rodrigo thinks about the three, ball knocked out from behind, scrambled for on the floor, out of bounds, heading to McEachern.
Everything's going McEachern's way. McEachern doing a good job of pressuring the basketball, forcing the help when it comes, and then all of a sudden, they're getting the rebounds.
McEachern coming into the game once again, ranked second in the country. They took their game on the road, played in tournaments in Tennessee, and all over the place playing any and all comers. Whistle on the inside off the missed three, and we're heading the other way. Foul on McEachern on the rebound. Played at the Tennessee Turkey Jam. Beat Memphis Overton, Memphis Central. That's the second foul on Dominique Wilson. So she is going to take a seat, and we are going to take a break. We are halfway through the first quarter of the girls' 5A title game. It has been all McEachern so far, 11-0 on Hillgrove. More from the arena at Gwinnett Center when we come back on GPB. Welcome back to the arena at Gwinnett Center. McEachern with the first 11 points on the board in the first 4 minutes and 2 seconds. McEachern 5 of 8 from the field to start. Hillgrove starting off 0 for their first 7.
That's the pressure that McEachern wants. Extended it at all times. Dead balls and made baskets, there's always going to be pressure.
Checking in for McEachern, Kayla Montgomery, the presence in the middle, heading to Clemson after this season. Double team in the corner, picked away. Coming back the other way, off the glass, no good. On the follow, up and in. That's what happens when you've got Montgomery in the middle.
Hey, she's about 6'5". She's going to Clemson, as you said. But she's going to be a little project. Got to get a little stronger, but she's long, she's tall, and she is a threat down low.
13-0 McEachern. Rodrigo with the basketball for Hillgrove, thinking of the three, takes it short. Rebound picked up on the inside by Montgomery. Back comes McEachern. Taya Cooper gives up on a flashing Montgomery, works it around. Inside Destiny Gibbs off the window, does not get the roll. Picked up by Mackenzie Ingram, the sophomore for Hillgrove. Hillgrove still searching for their first points on the board, 5 minutes in. McEachern up 13-0. Bounce pass, Schick, baseline, rimming, no. Follow, no good. Third shot in.
She had to stay with it. She had to stay with it. Missed the first one. I think she was intimidated by the presence of Montgomery, but she was able to get back and get the deuce.
Hillgrove's first two on the board now makes it 13-2, an 11-point ball game. Taya Cooper now at the basketball, top of the key. Gives it to her sister, and it's sister act back and forth right now, looking to figure out what they can do on the inside. Montgomery looking to set a screen to see if Cooper will penetrate. Gives up on the play. Now it's Mia Cooper, top of the circle, and steps.
That's a good thought by Montgomery. She's just not there to play on the perimeter. Got to get back inside, either set the ball screen, roll to the basket, or stay on the block.
Maisie Steed out. Meredith Heyer back in, handling the basketball now for the Lady Hawks. Trying to come up with another two. Penetration, Schick. higher once again, pulls up for the jumper, long. Rebound on the inside, picked up by McKenzie Ingram, up and in.
I like Ingram. I like Ingram, a sophomore. Only 15 years old. Strong move in the back to the basket for two.
Quickly back in transition, Taya Cooper.
You got to get back on defense. Transition. That's what McEachern does. You think you got them, bam, they're going to come back and score right in the face.
15-4, margin still at 11. Rodrigo giving to Diamond Thomas, looking to penetrate. Three tall trees in there for McEachern, gives up the basketball. Back comes Destiny Gibbs. Down the middle of the floor, pushed from behind. Looks like they're going to call Diamond Thomas for the foul.
Been talking to Coach Arthur last night. Her team, the way they spread you out, because they shoot the three ball so well, it spreads you out like Duke. They pick your poison. You want to defend us on the perimeter? We're going to penetrate. You want to cut off the inside? You're kicking that further outside shot.
Rebounds right there. You saw 6-5. McEachern with the slight edge. Looking to inbound is Gibbs. Gibbs finds Cooper. Cooper to Patches Roberts. Runner good.
Wow. Taking that to Syracuse. She's good.
17-4 McEachern now. Under 90 seconds to go. First quarter. A long first quarter for the Lady Hawks. Meredith Heyer ends up giving the ball back to Rodrigo after she slipped on the floor. Pull-up three is short by Marissa Lester. Rebound picked up by McEachern, and they are getting to it in transition. Taya Cooper, easy two, missed off the layup that time by Jocelyn Ramos now in the game for McEachern. Back come the Hawks.
Yeah, Ramos has to capitalize. That was an easy layup, another assist opportunity for Cooper.
Shot in the middle, block, fumbled around, picked up, trying to come up with it. They're going to call alternate possession, and it stays with Hillgrove. Here's the block again.
This Patches is doing a good job at stopping the penetration with the block, and there's a good tie-up. And I tell you what, McEachern is so aggressive. They play hard, and it's just aggressive. That's a great word to describe them, aggressive.
55 seconds and counting, first quarter. Hook shot up by Ingram, no good, but they'll call a foul on the inside. Looks like it's on Patches Roberts. But they'll call it on Kayla Montgomery instead. That's Montgomery's first.
15 years old at free throw line, Ingram. She's one of those stars we talked about. In 2 years, she'll be a name recognized around the nation.
They'll go trying to get into this 13-point deficit any way that they can. Ingram's second free throw is up. Rims out, no good. Rebound crash, ball goes to McEachern.
Now McEachern, this is their big lineup, believe it or not. You got Montgomery in at the five, and you've got Patches there at the four, so this is where they get a little big on you with some size.
Cooper, Montgomery, Robertson, Gibbs, three-point attempt, good.
Pick your poison, what do? You can't defend all positions.
Mia Cooper with the three, 20 points on the board for McEachern. The lead is now 16. Schick in trouble in traffic. Three McEachern bodies around her. They're going to call a whistle. They do now. But what's the call? Looks like the call's an offensive foul on Hillgrove. The foul is on Schick in the scrum.
Who was at the bottom of the pile there, John? Cooper.
All of them.
the first person down was Cooper. She committed to North Carolina already. Didn't even play 1 second of high school basketball. Shows you how good she is.
Well, you're averaging 12 points, 5 assists, and 3 steals a game. You know that Sylvia Hatchell is going to come calling. And she did it all the way back in August just to make sure that she wouldn't have to worry about the process anymore. Under 20 seconds to go. First quarter, Gibbs dribbling outside. Near wing looking for one shot. Taya Cooper looking to drive on Rodrigo. Spin move, knocked away. Hillgrove trying to come out with it under 5 seconds. Schick, Rodrigo, 3-2-1. Get it off in time. Yes, and got it.
Oh! Wait for us. Here I come. She stayed with the dribble. Nice shot.
And that is the way to end the quarter if you're Hillgrove. It was a long 8 minutes. But McEachern, after the first 8 minutes, is now up 20-7. One quarter down, second quarter coming up, 5A title game here on the great GPP. Back to the arena at Gwinnett Center after this. Welcome back to the arena at Gwinnett Center. First quarter in the books of the girls' 5A title game. McEachern up 20-7 over Hillgrove. Hillgrove had a rough start, down 11, 20-7 right now after one. And football fans, GPB Sports launches another great season of high school football with the Metro PCS Corky Cal Classic, August 25th, live from the Big Top, the Georgia Dome. 21st year of the Classic, bigger and better than ever. They've added a game. Now it's 10 teams televised live in HD across the state on GPB. Bright and early, breakfast, lunch, and dinner with GPB Sports starting at 9 a.m. Grayson, top recruit in the country, Robert Kimdichie. South Georgia powerhouses Camden and Colquitt football junkies tune in August 25th, 14 hours of high school football right there. And the McEachern cheerleaders had a lot to cheer about in that first quarter, Sean.
Well, hey, 20-7, that's all you can do is keep cheering because the game's going to get a little bit better, I think, for McEachern. They did a great job attacking it, going to the offensive glass, shooting an open shot, and doing a great job of defending.
60% from the floor for McEachern in the first, 9-15. Hillgrove 3-16. McEachern with the rebounding edge, 9-6. Second quarter now underway. It is the three-pointer launched off the front of the rim, no good, by McEachern. Back in transition, it is Marissa Lester. Lester to Rodrigo. Rodrigo will direct traffic, guarded by Destiny Gibbs. Rodrigo hit the big three from just inside half court at the end of the first. Shot by Ingram, blocked in the paint. Coming back out with it, Taya Cooper. Cooper looking. Her pass was deflected to Destiny Gibbs. Off the rim, no good. Rebound picked up by Maisie Steed. Long outlet pass to Ingram. Ingram pulls up off the window. Missed it. And McEachern comes back with the rebound, crashing the boards. They had three blue jerseys there to the one for the Lady Hawks.
I tell you what, these kids from McEachern are saying, we got to win, and we're going to win with a team effort.
Dominique Wilson at point, looking for Gibbs to come out for a little help. Try to draw Hillgrove out of that defensive zone. Knocked out of bounds by Ingram, stays with McEachern.
I was really shocked that Hillgrove came out and played man-to-man. I thought they would have started with a zone. I'd give you the open shot on the perimeter, but I'm not going to give you the inside as well.
Jump shot from the elbow is good by Patches Roberts. Now it's 22-7. Back comes Hillgrove.
Okay, Patches is putting on a clinic. She said, I'm going to Syracuse up in the cold weather, but I'm going to be hot when I go there with this stroke.
Patches now with six of McEachern's 22. Mia Cooper had six in the first quarter as well. Rodrigo looking for motion on the inside. Guarded by Taya Cooper. Inside Ingram. Ingram looking for help, trying to find it wherever she can. Three McEachern players collapse. Rodrigo pull-up jumper off the back of the rim, no good. On the inside, off the glass, up and good, Marissa Lester.
That's good putback right there for number 24 for the Hawks. Good putback, getting them on the board for 9 points.
Margin back to 13 at 22-9. 2 minutes gone, turnover, pass goes astray. We're heading back to Hillgrove's direction.
Starting to see a little life in Hillgrove. Thinking, hey, in the second quarter, getting a little confidence. We've got past that first quarter jitters. See if they can make a run.
Rodrigo almost had two players on her collapse just before half court. Maisie Steed kicks it back so Rodrigo can set up the offense. 5:50 and counting first half. McEachern up 13, 22-9. Ingram off the elbow, pass to Steed, kicks it back out. Higher, three, off the front of the rim, no good. Rebound kicked around on the inside. And coming out with it, Taya Cooper from McEachern.
Taya Cooper's a floor general. Look how she handles the ball, controls the tempo of the game. Make sure everyone's in front of her.
Kicks it near side, Gibbs. Looking to drive into the paint, off the window, no good. Rebound picked up on the inside by Ingram. Ingram to Rodrigo, nice outlet pass to Heyer, misses the shot off the front of the rim. Back comes McEachern again, in transition. And they're gonna pull it back out to try it again. Dominique Wilson set up three, Patches misses. Tries to fight for the rebound after it goes through a couple of different bodies. McEachern picks it back up to reset 3 minutes in.
Always deepest rule, long shots, long rebounds.
Dominique Wilson looking inside. They're trying to draw Hillgrove out of this zone pressure. And that leaves the paint wide open for the drive and two.
It's a good drive, good drive. Going to Arkansas, going to take a good game out there to raise it back country.
Rodrigo double teamed, gets past it, dribbles almost into the paint. Heyer thinks about the three, kicks it back out. Working rotation, jump shot, Lester off the back of the rim, no good. And there's Patches Robertson for the rebound. We got a jump ball situation, alternate possession, State of Hillgrove.
Roberts is doing it all. Patches is doing everything you can imagine. And she's rebounding, she's scoring, she's doing all the things to keep her game in play.
And here's the last two on the board. Nice dribble drive there. Easy, too, for Dominique Wilson. Her first two of the ball game. 4:26 to go first half. McEachern up 15, 24-9. Off the elbow, shot no good by Steed. Picked up Gibbs. Outlet. It is to Dominique Wilson. Wilson pulls up, jump shot, long, no good. Into the game now, it is Kayla Montgomery. Bounces inside, pass again for two.
I'll tell you what, clockwork, that team is really well coached. But when you got players like Cooper on the court, you got Patches on the court, it's really hard to defend all those young girls.
26-9, back up to 17, halfway home in the first half. Rodrigo, pass to Heyer, shot off the rim, no good. Long rebound once again in transition. Roberts for the easy two.
Another timeout coming up, I think, Coach. You really need something right here to control and slow the tempo down. If I'm on Hillgrove, just really allow my girls to take their time.
Rodrigo now double-teamed in front of the McEachern bench. They're going to call a foul on Taya Cooper at the 3:38 mark. And since we are past halfway of the second quarter, that means that we are going to take a little bit of a blow ourselves. McEachern up 19, 28-9 over Hillgrove in the girls' 5A championship battle of Region 4. Finishes up the second quarter when we come back on the great GPB from the arena at Gwinnett Center. Welcome back to the arena at Gwinnett Center. 3:38 to go first half. McEachern up 28-9. We'll get back to the action in just a sec. But hey, did you know? GPB Sports' Mark Harmon and Herb White center court, center stage during the halftime of the 5A boys game coming up. The top three dunkers in the state of Georgia that have been voted the best rim rockers in the state of Georgia. You voted online now. You can now see them live in action with all of their high-flying artistry. The GPB Sports AJC Slam Dunk Competition, the half of the 5A boys game, around 9:30 or so. So stay with us here on the great GPB.
Is Herb White going to dunk?
I think the elevator. Oh, I'd like to see the elevator from Decatur get some dunking time in. I don't know. I don't know if
he's a skyrocketing guy now. He could get up.
Oh, and that's the thing. That's why I always make sure to stay out of the way. And if I need something off the top shelf, I always go to Herb. Second quarter field goal percentages right now: McEachern 5 of 9, 56%. Hillgrove 1 of 7 for 14%. Hillgrove started out the game 0 for 9. Hit their next 3 out of their next 7. Now they're 1 of their last 7. So it's ebbs and flows right now for Cheryl Fowler and the Hillgrove Lady Hawks right there. There's your numbers, 14 of 24 overall. Hillgrove 3 for 23.
Well, that's the defense by McEachern. Also, I think there's a little nervousness in there as well, too.
Rodrigo, dribble, drive, dish, Maisie Steed, up and in, counter.
When you're playing a team like McEachern, the best way to hit them is get them in the heart, get them right there in the guts of the paint, and now get to the free throw line for an and one.
Steed heading to the free throw line to try to complete the three-point play, and foul on Destiny Gibbs, her first. 15th foul for McEachern, only 2 for Hillgrove. Near corner, Gibbs kicks it back out to Dominique Wilson. Far side, Taya Cooper has Gibbs open on the wing, throws it up, and they're going to call a whistle and a foul on the drive.
Cooper just having that presence as a freshman to really know when to attack, know when to bring it out. I tell you what, she's been on a basketball all her life.
Meredith Heyer called for the foul, her first long entry pass. Cooper, Gibbs looking inside. Wilson open far court, doesn't see her. Back to Taya, dribble drive, Destiny Gibbs, pull up jumper, good.
Balance scoring about this McEachern team. Each person can score 20 points, so you got to pick your poison. Where are you going to defend? The three, the individuals?
Transition again off the turnover. Taya Cooper with the layup.
Got to protect the basketball against this McEachern team.
And once again, McEachern collapsing around the Lady Hawks. You see two or three bodies anytime that basketball hits the floor and someone knows that they can't move it any further. Another alternate possession call on the jump ball. We're heading the other way with McEachern.
Again, who's the first one on the floor?
I believe that would be a Cooper.
There you go. She's tough. She is tough. She's ratty. Gonna love in the Chapel Hill.
Gibbs inbounding to Taya Cooper, back to Gibbs. Directing traffic, cross-court pass, looking for it. Dominic Wilson couldn't handle a turnover. 20-point game, McEachern, 32-12. 2:20 and counting, first half. The task for Celia Rodrigo, over and back, or a foul. We're going to call a foul first, okay. Fouls on Taya Cooper, and that'll be her second foul. And in comes Mia Cooper to replace her younger sister. Coach Arthur says that Mia is the more laid back of the two. The older one's the more laid back over the younger one?
I think sometimes that happens. I have two daughters myself. My youngest one is very intense.
Coming up on the 2-minute mark, first half, 20-point lead for McEachern, 32-12. Celia Rodrigo trying to direct traffic and get some kind of penetration on the baseline. Does block. Kayla Montgomery with the presence in the middle. And you're going to see it coming up right here.
This Montgomery just timing it perfectly. All ball, good block.
Mackenzie Ingram checking out. Tiffany Schick checking back in. And she is blocked when she gets the entry pass. Shot up and in for Selena Rodrigo.
Montgomery just showing her presence down low. I'm the tallest on the court. I'll be aggressively, defensively getting some blocks. But when she blocks, her teammates have got to secure that rebound and not give opportunities to score the basket.
Rodrigo with the free throw to cut it to 32-15. Last night in the semifinal against North Gwinnett, she ended up with 12 of the fourth quarter, 22 points that Hillgrove scored. And there's the basket right there by Kayla Montgomery in the paint.
I tell you, that's an advantage for McEachern. They can go small with it, but then when they go big, they bring Montgomery in. She's showing her presence down low. That's catching it with a quick drop step to the basket.
Rodrigo marked by Gibbs. Lesser. Trying to figure out if she can do something into the paint. Kicks it back to Rodrigo, who'll drive into the paint. Loses control. We're going to call a foul. Getting ready to check back in are Ingram and Heyer for the Lady Hawks. Jocelyn Ramos now checking in for McEachern. Destiny Gibbs will take a seat. Diamond Thomas out for the Lady Hawks, as well as Maisie Steed. First free throw by Rodrigo is good. Eighth team foul for McEachern. Hillgrove only with three. Rodrigo in the semifinal, we were making the point about how she scored 12 of the team's 22. 11 of 13 were from the line. This is the second there. 70 seconds and counting, first half. McEachern up 34-16 over Hillgrove. Patches, Wilson. Near corner, Cooper. Thought about the three, kicked it back out to Dominique Wilson, who will reset. Guarded by Lester. Pass far side to Mia Cooper. Cooper and Rodrigo are a pair. Pull up jumper, good.
Nice touch. I think that's Cooper's third three for the game. She's got a beautiful touch.
37-16, 40 seconds to go, first half. Rodrigo looking once again, baseline penetration. Kicks it to Schick. Schick into the paint, running left hand, partially blocked that time by Kayla Montgomery. McEachern back with it.
Montgomery just being a beast down low, showing how she can defend and block a few shots.
Roberts, Wilson, shot no good. Rodrigo with the rebound. Looks like they're going to call Patches Roberts for the foul as she was guarding Rodrigo coming up the floor. 18 seconds to go, first half, a long first half for Hillgrove. McEachern leading by 21. There's Phyllis Arthur. Trying to go coast to coast, undefeated. Once again, ranked second in the country coming into this particular game. She played any and all comers in a couple of tournaments. The Jump Off Holiday Invitational played Hollywood Christian, Hoover, and Riverdale of Tennessee. Tennessee Turkey Jam, Memphis Overton, and Memphis Central. So she's not afraid to take her team on the road to do some damage. Rodrigo.
Last night against Diamond DeShields, they did a great job of defending her. I mean, they played a box of one, but they played a straight up man-to-man. These girls took on the challenge and was able to take it home with a W, get a chance to play today for the state championship.
10 seconds and counting, first half. They're going to play for one. Catches Roberts, throwing to clear out the paint, looking to get something off the elbow, throws it off right hand, no good. Rodrigo looking, timing it again, throws it up ahead, blocked away, trying to get the easy two. Dominic Wilson knocks it out of bounds, and that is the end of a very long first half for Hillgrove in this battle of Region 4 for the 5A championship. McEachern leading by 19, 37 to 18. Lindsay Theory now has head coach Phyllis Arthur of the McEachern Indians. Lindsay, what's up?
All right, Coach. Well, last night after the big win over Norcross, you said there was no danger of this team having a letdown. You've got to be pretty pleased with how they've opened this game up.
Yeah, I'm fairly pleased on offense. We can move around a little bit more. Right now, we're not moving our feet on defense. We're trying to go for steals, and we picked up some lazy fouls.
All right, Coach. Well, good luck in the second half.
All right, thank you very much.
Okay, Mark, let's go over to you on the set.
Lindsay, thanks so much. We are at halftime of the 5A girls game right now with McEachern leading Hillgrove 37-18. Coming up at the half, we'll hear from both principals. We'll also have a special report on the upcoming slam dunk exhibition from Jackie Britton. We'll also have first half highlights and stats. It's all coming up on the GBB Championship halftime show right now. McEachern and Hillgrove 37-18, your score at the halftime break. We're back after this timeout. Welcome back to Championship Weekend here on GPB. We will have 10 championship games tonight and tomorrow night. It's a lot of excitement here on GPB. And we welcome to the show at the halftime of the girls' 5A game, McEachern and Hillgrove, the principal at Hillgrove High School, Dr. Robert Shaw. Thanks for being with us.
My pleasure. Thanks for having me.
What's been the vibe over at Hillgrove High School this week as you make the semifinals and then make the championship game?
It's been very exciting. And, of course, to play McEachern, who's one of our biggest rivals. The kids have all been excited. Both the last 2 days, we've done a spirit walk where the drumline and the cheerleaders have escorted the girls out onto the bus to take them to this arena. And we even had the eighth graders from the middle school next door out to cheer our girls on. So it's been a great vibe, great atmosphere, a lot of excitement, and we're very excited to be here.
All right. There's a lot of big things going at Hillgrove High School these days.
Well, a lot of things. We are actually achieved platinum level for our student performance. We were also named a 2011 School of Excellence. So the academic side, we're doing very, very well. Athletically, our football team was undefeated region champs. Softball team finished third in state. And, of course, our girls basketball team are just doing an amazing job and some of the best kids and coaches you'd ever want to meet. And I love them to death, and I couldn't be prouder of them.
All right, it's time now. We were on for our football football Fridays in Georgia. We asked you a question from the Georgia graduation test. This is not going to be on the Georgia graduation test, but
That's
it is
good.
A question. We want to know your tonsorial masterpiece. So check this out. What is this masterpiece called? It's associated with the rock culture. It was derived from the Iroquois Indians, Native Americans. Some people use glue and egg whites or cornstarch to hold that thing together. What is that hairdo called?
Well, I think I've seen it a few times at school. I'm going to go with mohawk.
Mohawk, you are right. I didn't have one like that, but it's eye-catching.
Well, when I had hair, I used to make one like that, but I don't do that anymore.
Well, listen, thanks so much for coming on with us.
Well,
we appreciate it.
Thank you for having us, and again, thank you for supporting high school athletics, and we appreciate all that you guys do.
All right, coming up next at the halftime of the 5A game, we've got a very special event coming your way, and Jackie Britton is here to tell us all about it. Jackie?
Thanks, Mark. That's right. The dunking exhibition is coming up in just a little bit. But first, let's take a look at some of those all-stars that you'll see out there on the court. What really makes a slam dunk a slam dunk? Is it the style, the speed, or the overall movement that propels a player into the air with a powerful surge, ending with the ball in the hoop and the crowd on their feet? Anything you've seen in the NBA, you'll see in these contestants of the AJC Dunk Contest. Entries started coming in when an AJC writer introduced the dunk contest through his blog. With the help of the fans, the AJC was able to narrow down the top 10, then 5, and then the final 3. Those top 3 proved to be the best of the best. Shaq Goodwin, a senior at Southwest DeKalb, who signed with the University of Memphis. At 6'8", not much stops him from a little 3-on-1 before finishing with an elbow dunk. And how about Dawson Womack from North Cobb Christian? Another power forward soars over another person before slamming one in.
And finally, Chris Bolden, a senior at North Gwinnett High, who's committed to Georgia Tech, doesn't have any additional tricks, just a traditional slam dunk. After weeks of voting, the winner isn't left up to a panel of judges, but to the fans. Each fan can vote once every hour. And whether you like the winner or not, no one can deny that a slam dunk is one of those things that always seems to stun the crowd.
All right, and Shaq Goodwin, who goes to Southwest DeKalb at 6'8", won the AJC dunk contest. We just saw him out there on the court, so congratulations to him. Mark, I'll send it back over to you.
Jackie, thanks so much. We want to welcome down into the program the principal of McEachern High School, Regina Montgomery. Thanks for coming on with us.
Thank you for having me.
You have had an outstanding season with these girls. They are undefeated, ranked number one in Georgia, number two in the country.
We have had a great season. They're a great group of girls.
What's the vibe like out there at McEachern High School for the girls' team?
Nothing but excitement. You know, as you said, we're ranked number one in the region, number two in the nation, number one in the state. And as I said, the girls are great. So put those two things together and you have nothing but excitement.
You know, we were over there for the football season. I mean, you guys win a lot of games in football, too.
We did. We had an outstanding football season. Didn't end up where we wanted to end up, but that just gives us something to work harder for.
A lot of good building projects going on there.
That's correct. We just opened our new health and physical education center. And we're doing a great job. The kids are outstanding.
Now, I know you didn't want to play the Are You Smarter game from the Georgia graduation test, so we've got another question for you.
Okay.
Know your tonsorial masterwork. Now, that is something. What is that called? It's a wig for men. It was made fashionable in the 17th and 18th centuries. It was a vital part of the upper class of the French and British households. What is that thing called?
Periwig.
You are right. They rang the bell. I didn't know the answer
all
to that
right.
one either, but you
all
are
right.
correct.
I think I saw that in some book.
A periwig.
Yes.
I like that. Well, thanks for coming on and good luck
Thank
in the second half.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
All right. Coming up, it's almost time for the second half. We'll be back with more, some halftime highlights and statistics when we come back after this timeout. Stay with us. It is championship weekend here on GPB. Time now to get ready for the second half of the girls' Class 5A championship game between top-ranked McEachern and Hillgrove. And so for the call of the second half, we send it to John Nelson and Sean Golden.
Thank you very much, Mark Harmon. Before we go any further here in the first half, heading toward the second half, let's send it over to Lindsay Theory, who has caught up with Coach Fowler to find out about the Hillgrove point of view. Lindsay.
Coach, obviously not the way you wanted to start the game out in that first half. What are your thoughts?
We're just got to keep plugging. The kids got to play, keep their heads up, and just hopefully the second half the shots will start falling for them.
All right, good luck, Coach.
Thank you.
All right, John, let's go right back over to you.
Thank you very much, Lindsay. Time, Coach, to check out the first half highlights and stats, and it was a long first half for Hillgrove, as we just heard from Coach Fowler. Let's check it out right here.
Well, first of all, McEachern is going to continue to attack. They're going to keep that pressure on. Stay focused if I'm McEachern. You got to play hard, play smart, definitely play together. You got a chance to make good history out here.
Patches Roberts knocking down a couple of shots on her own, and then it's the elder Cooper, Mia Cooper, with the three there. And then Destiny Gibbs the pull up from the baseline. That'll rim down, and there's the defense that you're talking about.
Exactly. It just tipped from behind, uncontested layup.
And the younger Cooper, Taya, with that last shot there. 18 of 30, McEachern, 60% in the first half. Dominic Wilson leads them with 9. Hillgrove, 5 of 28 from the floor, 18%. Anything else stick out to you there?
I tell you, really, here's the key that's going to happen for this second half. The first 2 minutes of the half, after the second half, that's the key. Who sets the tone? If Hillgrove's going to come out and play hard, or McEachern's going to come out and punch him real quickly.
All right, things to pay attention to. Destiny Gibbs for McEachern, 34, has 3 fouls, so that could prove to send Coach Arthur to the bench deeper than she could. Selena Rodrigo led Hillgrove with 7 points in the first half. And there's that pressure defense again from McEachern. Tie up, alternate possession, sends it the other way.
Setting the tone early. The first 2 minutes of the second half, that's when you set the tone, how you want this game to finish up.
10 seconds in, McEachern right now with a 19-point lead on Hillgrove here in the girls' 5A championship from the arena at Gwinnett Center. Dribble drive, and they're going to call, looks like a foul on Marissa Lester on the drive right there by Taya Cooper.
Yeah, Patches in the corner. You got Cooper penetrating. He couldn't help. Cooper was able to get in, get to the free throw line.
On Once again, we talk about Taya Cooper in the semifinal against Norcross. 18 points, 3 assists, 3 rebounds, 5 steals, an all-around performance for her. First free throw up and good.
She's got a heart of a lion. When you have that type of heart, you have that type of fighting, you're going to be able to excel. Plus, she's a very talented yet smart young woman.
Second free throw good. Lead back up to 21 at 39-18. McEachern comes out pressing, no surprise. Lester thinks about driving, kicks it back out, and they will start it all over again. Rodrigo, top of the circle, picked up by Dominique Wilson. Higher looking to drive, pressure from behind by Cooper. And they're going to call a foul there as the jumper went up.
Hillgrove's coming out, going to pass the ball around, side, top, side, being able to penetrate, pull up, get to the free throw line, chance to cut to the lead.
Lester's first free throw, good. First foul on Mia Cooper there. Lester getting a look from Emory University, playing some Division III ball down the line. 39-20. McEachern right now in control, still pressing and pressuring, but Heyer comes out with it in the paint, and that's going to be a foul on Gibbs, and I think that's 4.
Still a fight in Hillgrove. They're coming out, they're playing a little bit more intensity. You see the clapping of the bench. That's what they need. Let's get this game a little bit closer and stay more focused.
There's Heyer coming out of the pack and right there, going for the swipe. And they call the whistle.
You got to play defense with your feet. You heard Coach talked about that before halftime. The girls are being too hungry trying to get the easy steals.
So then what do? You bring in Kayla Montgomery for Destiny Gibbs. Heyer, pull up 3. Looks long, is long, misses everything. And they're going to call Mia Cooper over the back.
John, as I said, this is when you got to stay focused. Right now, it looks like McEachern may have lost a little bit of that focus and that determination early in the second half.
Lester thought about the 3, drove into the paint, picked up by the big one, Montgomery. Back comes Cooper. Mia Cooper falls down on the floor, trying to keep her dribbling, keep possession. Wise timeout called by Coach Arthur for the 30.
You can see the frustration in Coach Arthur's eyes and want to get her team jailed and get them back focused.
And for those of you trying to pay attention to the other action going on down in AAA in Macon, Washington County girls win 68-52. They will play the winner of the second semifinal, first semifinal. And AAA boys went to Drew, a new school, 75-61 over Washington High. Minute 15 in, and this is last year. You look at what's going on. It was a long year for Coach Arthur last year going up against Norcross. Norcross had the better of them that time, and that's how it ended up with McEachern advancing to that first semifinal last year, losing 61-36. Coming back at it this time around, pass inside Montgomery. We're going to call possession turnover heading back to Hillgrove.
McEachern a little sloppy. I think it's time for them to pick it up, force the tempo with their press, the half-court trap.
Minute and a half in, McEachern 19-point lead. Heyer thinks of the 3, takes the 3, got it.
Oh, that's a beautiful shot. She's got a nice stroke. Picture-perfect stroke. Be able to get the 3, cut the lead into 16.
Cooper and Cooper, the law firm, bringing it up the floor for the Indians. They're going to be around for one more year. And you've got Taya, the ninth grader. And we'll try another 3 on that end. Shot no good by Patches Roberts. Then Roberts goes in after the rebound, and they call steps on Rodrigo.
See Coach Arthur starting a sub. When she see her players not listening and following the game plan, sit them down on the bench a little bit, get their mind right, they'll get back in the game.
Ramos looking inside to Montgomery. Shot is no good, but whistles. Third quarter field goals, Hillgrove is 0-for-2. McEachern, until that shot by Montgomery, had not attempted a field goal in the first 2 minutes. Fouls on Heyer, her second. Free throw up, off the rim, no good.
Go, 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 go.
Kayla Montgomery, 6'5", heading to Clemson after this season. Second free throw short. You saw it come out of her hands a little funny. Higher on the floor, trying to scramble for it. Maisie Steed has the basketball for the Lady Hawks. Give to Rodrigo, clearing traffic. Trying to get into the paint, does. Dribble drive. Nice play.
Wow. Now, that's a good move. That's a good move. That's why she's going to Wake Forest and playing in the ACC. Great move by Rodrigo.
Hillgrove has it down to 14, 39-25. Cooper trying to drive on Steed. Montgomery at the free throw line. Jumper off the rim. No good. Picked up on the inside by Ramos. No good. Is there a third chance involved? Scramble on the floor. Foul called. And it looks like the foul's going to be called on Hillgrove. There's Rodrigo driving to the bucket. She also got called for the foul on this end.
I tell you what, when she gets the ball in her hands, when she starts to create and get her mind to it, good things happen. She's a good player. Just didn't have the talent around her that McEachern has, but she's a very good player.
7-0 Hillgrove run to get it to 14 at the 5:28 mark. Montgomery outside, top of the key, three-point. Speaking of three-point, Wilson gets it.
I tell you what, she can shoot that thing. She can really shoot the rock.
Heading to Arkansas, averaging 15 points a game and 3.5 rebounds. Heyer thinks about the three again, hits it off of Patches Roberts' knee, gets it back. Kick back in, Rodrigo driving again off the glass and good.
She's starting to wake up. She knows in order for their team to have a chance, she's got to put them on her back.
Rodrigo now with 11 of Hillgrove's 27, back to 15. Under 5 minutes to go, third quarter. Intercepted Ingram. Ingram trying to go coast to coast with it, has traffic behind, and that's what happened.
I like Ingram. 15 years old, sophomore, athletic, aggressive, tough. And she's only going to get better.
Third foul on Taya Cooper, who came in from behind. So she's got 8 points to go with her three fouls, and it looks like Coach Arthur's calling a timeout.
That's a wake-up call, timeout. Sometimes you got to wake them up a little bit with the timeout, jump into them a little bit, get the fire lit. Hopefully they'll come back out with a little bit better focus.
And I talk about the story with Hillgrove, and we'll get to that in just a second, but we have some other important business to talk to you about. It has to do with life on the flats. Georgia Tech Whiz Kids have teamed up to compete for cash and a U.S. patent. Third quarter field goals, Hillgrove 3 of 5, McEachern 1 of 4. We're going to talk about Rodrigo, who's been very, very busy here third quarter.
Just attacking a rim. She knows she's got to score. Let me get some opportunities, get to the paint, kiss it off the glass. She's an electrifying player, just doesn't have the depth that McEachern has, but I love watching her play.
Ingram to the free throw line. 4:51 to go, third quarter. Once again, it's down to 15, so let's see what kind of damage Mackenzie Ingram can do here. Spin of the ball, free throw short.
Wow, she's got a beautiful body. She's a great post player. She's going to gain about 10 pounds over her career here in high school, being able to take it to the next level. And I think she's going to be a good player in the next level in college.
Working with that tape in the palm and the two taped fingers off the edge. Rotation, splash. Down to 14, 42-28. Hillgrove chipping away. And intercepted by Ingram again in the middle. Lester pulls it back out to Rodrigo. Rodrigo marked by Cooper. She'll pull it back out to reset. 4.5 to go, third quarter. Inside to Ingram. Ingram on Montgomery off the foot. Back to Rodrigo, though. Once again, resetting is Hillgrove. Ingram fighting for position in the paint, looking for the entry pass. Knocked away from Montgomery, but got it anyway. Shot no good. Rebound picked up by Cooper. Bodies all over the floor. Coming back out with it, it's Wilson from McEachern. Driving off against Rodrigo. Mia Cooper thought about the three. Gives it to her sister, Taya, who sets the offense. Montgomery posted high. Looks like Patches Roberts looking to drive. Amazing Steve does. Shot no good. Cooper. And again, Wilson, three-pointer, no. Fought for four bodies in there. Roberts, Montgomery, now we're adding three Hillgrove players. Alternate possession sends it the other way.
Now you can see the intensity of Hillgrove picked up. That time there were two white shirts on the floor, one blue shirt, so now the aggressive one is definitely Hillgrove.
We are 3:45 to go, third quarter. McEachern's lead down to 14. What's Hillgrove gonna do? We'll find out when we come back to the arena at Gwinnett Center on GPB. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the arena, Gwinnett Center. Halfway through the third quarter, McEachern leading Hillgrove 42-28. Let's flash back to last year. Phyllis Arthur had an entirely different experience. Angie Hembree, the head coach for Norcross, the team that they fought in the semifinals this year, there was her pedigree getting into the game, and the game was all diamond to Shields. To Shields with the pass there for the easy two. Norcross up 17 at that point, fourth quarter, and to Shields with the pick. She'll go coast to coast. Norcross wins it by 25 to get the 5A title last year, an entirely different experience from McEachern this time around here in 2012. And a lot of people were here at that game last night thinking that Norcross and McEachern, that was going to be a fantastic ball game, and it was, to get us to this point here.
Oh, you're exactly right. Norcross and McEachern, big rivalry game. But McEachern was able to come out on top because they hit shots last night, and they did a good job defensively on Diamond Shields.
Talk about single-digit wins. That win against Norcross last night was only one of five that McEachern has had to deal with this year. Three to Memphis Central, two against North Cobb, one by nine, one by three, one against Hillgrove, matchup number two in February, 43-37, and the game last night where they won by three. So only five of the 32 wins have been by single digits.
Well, it shows you they know how to win close games, but do they know how to put games away? Because they were up by at least 12 points last night versus Norcross, had a chance to extend it, just couldn't get over the hump.
Let's see what Hillgrove does on possession. Coming up on 3.5 to go in the third. Higher dribbling inside to Rodrigo, looking to pass. Outlet, Steed, baseline, off the rim, no good. Tries to get her own rebound, picked up by Lester, and they'll reset. Higher to Rodrigo, guarded by Patches Roberts. Higher thinks about the three, dribbles inside, kicks it out. Ingram, free throw, rims out, no good. Position by Steed, blocked by Wilson, and back comes McEachern.
That's that tenacious defense we talked about McEachern has. Now they got to capitalize.
Four bodies on the floor, two on two. Declaria Daniels now in the game for McEachern. She's at the bottom of that pile along with Rodrigo.
I'm sure Coach Fowler at halftime really put some fire on these young girls. Now you're starting to see them get on the floor for a loose ball and sacrifice their bodies for the team.
3 minutes and counting in the third. Drive, no good by Wilson. Picked up by Heyer, who hands to Rodrigo, and they'll cross half court. As we said, Hilda chipping away, down 11-0. Hard start coming back off the window. Rims out, no good. Picked up in the corner by Rodrigo. Kicks it back out and around. Ingram thinks about the 17-footer. Thinks against it. Three-pointer attempt. Lester is off, misses everything. Steve can't save it. Heads to McEachern.
Tell you what, when Ingram really understands how good she can be and gets that confidence, I think she's going to hit those shots because she's had two or three point-blank range opportunities, just didn't get it into the cup.
Mia Cooper, Jocelyn Ramos in the game. Daniels will sit, as will Montgomery. Third quarter field goal percentages. McEachern 20%, 1 of 5. Hillgrove 3 of 7, 38%.
One of the toughest things to do when you're up by a large lead going into halftime, it's hard to stay focused and keep that drive because you kind of take a deep breath. I think that's what McEachern did. They got to find that drive back so they can really extend this lead.
Double dribble, sixth turnover now for McEachern. And Hillgrove hanging around.
You look at the body language of McEachern. Just look, they lost that edge, and they've got to get the edge back. A couple of runs will definitely do that. But Hillgrove doing a good job of attacking the press and hitting some shots.
2-1-2 press. Hillgrove does end up beating it. Rodrigo was initially trapped deep in her own territory. Picked up by Cooper, and Cooper thinking about it. Down along the baseline, Diamond Thomas loses possession. Gets it back, looking for Schick. Alternate possession, stays with Hillgrove.
Rodrigo, it's always one against two. She's being double-teamed with the ball. She's having to do it all. Handle the pressure, score.
Misses everything on the three-point attempt, so we're sending it back the other way.
Well, maybe a strategy for this McEachern, let's try to fatigue her, wear her down so she won't be as effective in the fourth quarter.
Tipped out of bounds, stays with Hillgrove. They'll try it again. This time, it is Heyer missing with the three, but Ingram is called for the push-off.
Yeah, she did. She got that left arm in there, extended a little bit. She had position. All she had to do was let the ball come to her.
Second foul for Heyer there. Ingram tries to go for the intercept again, knocked out of bounds at the 147 mark, still at 14 points. And a lot of this has been done with Destiny Gibbs sitting on the bench with four fouls. That 8 points per game average is sitting on the pine. Intercepted, Ingram with the block going in on the foul. Players coming in from both sides, and we're gonna, looks like it's gonna be called on Dominic Wilson. That'll be Wilson's second foul. Fourth foul for McEachern. Hillgrove with five here in the third. 1:40 to go, 14-point advantage. It's been on 14 for quite some time. Hillgrove has had a lot of opportunities to try to trim it to 12, 10, or less, but they haven't been able to convert. Catches Roberts, puts up a shot, no good. Rebound, Schick. Schick looking to pass to Rodrigo. Battled for with Wilson. Wilson knocks it out of bounds, stays with Hillgrove.
And Hillgrove's fighting. I mean, you got to give them all the credit. They're fighting. They're giving everything they got. Just not, I don't think they have the, I wouldn't say talent in a negative way, but just don't have the ability to score at will just like McEachern.
Steed in, higher out for the Lady Hawks as Lester brings it up the floor. Hands to Rodrigo, who'll set up the offense. It's the signal from head coach Cheryl Fowler, dribbling on Dominique Wilson, a high dribble, tries to get out of trouble, does, hands to Lester. Lester back to Rodrigo, resetting once more. Trying to find a way to drive on Cooper, can't, double teamed in the corner. Is she gonna get out of it? Yes, she does. Lester to Ingram, way outside, waiting for Rodrigo to get back to her feet so she can reset. Look at the pressure that they're putting on Rodrigo on a foul on Patches Roberts.
Always two on one, I tell you what. For her to handle that type of pressure and split it and get the foul, that shows you she's tough and handles the ball really strong and effective. Her teammates got to step up and hit some shots to help her out.
First on Patches Roberts. They're going to give Roberts a bit of a blow. Kayla Montgomery now in the ball game. Maisie Steed dribbling on Mia Cooper. Knocked out from behind by Cooper. Stays with Hillgrove at 53.8. left in the third. Hillgrove kind of loitering at the 42-28, a 14-point deficit. Chipped away from 21 down to 14 here in the third. Lester driving, off the rim, no good. Ingram gets position, blocked from behind by Montgomery. Jocelyn Ramos trying to do something with it, and we got another foul. Correction, stepped on the end line. Thank you very much, Steve Graham. Better eyes than I have.
The eye in the sky.
Hillgrove once again. Ingram, Lester, three. Rim, no good. Picked up Dominic Wilson. And we're heading the other way. Foul on Hillgrove.
And Wilson's doing a good job having an all-around game. Hit threes early in the half. Now she's coming out. She's having to do a good job of rebounding for this team.
38 and a half seconds to go, third quarter. McEachern still with a 14-point lead. Driving on Lester all the way down, pass up and rim out with the basket. Schick battling with Montgomery on the inside, up for the basket again. Jocelyn Ramos, no.
Cooper with a little shake and bake, get down. A teammate didn't finish and give her the assist. And she's gonna get you the free throw line. Hopefully she can put down two.
Tiffany Schick with the foul. Tiffany Schick moved into Hillgrove's region from Texas last year, so she's getting her first example of Georgia high school basketball. And she's getting an entitled game of 28.2. Second free throw up and good by Jocelyn Ramos, back to a 15-point lead. Rodrigo, marked by Taya Cooper, looking to finish up the last 18 seconds or so of the third quarter. They're going to play for one. Rodrigo looking to drive on a high-low.
Watch the double team.
Screen by Lester. Doesn't take it. Tries to kick it out even further. Looking for Steed. Steed for three. Misses everything. Air ball with 2.1. So McEachern will have 2 seconds to do whatever they please. Did it hit McEachern on the way out? Looks like it did. So it's going to be a catch and shoot with 2.1. Ingram. He's going to have to think about it. You got time. Got it.
And she hits it.
Second time in the game that Hillgrove has ended the quarter with a long-distance jumper. McEachern had a 21-point lead at the half. It is now down to 12. Third quarter is in the books. We are heading to the fourth quarter here at the arena at Gwinnett Center. The 5A title hanging in the balance right here on the great GPB. Stay with us. Welcome back to the arena at Gwinnett Center. A 21-point game is now down to 12 for the final 8 minutes. Top seed out of Region 4, McEachern, ranked second in the country, had a 21-point lead at the half, Sean. Now after three, it's down to 12. Everything seems to be collapsing into 1 point.
Well, this is the first time here. So when it's your first time here, you can smell the roses. You get a little tight. They've got to loosen up, got to stay aggressive, and be positive the entire fourth quarter. If they do that, cut down on the turnovers, they'll be cutting down nets.
Last game for Cheryl Fowler as head coach of Hillgrove as well. So they're trying to send her out on top after 30 years as a head coach in Cobb County. Here are the final 8 minutes. Taya Cooper to her sister Mia, back and forth, working their way around. Wilson trying for the shot in the paint, no good. Ingram comes out with it, running the floor. Has Lester, tries to find her. Intercepted by Patches Roberts, knocked out of bounds, stays with Hillgrove.
Ingram's being a beast. She's starting to wake up a little bit and playing tenacious defense.
Rodrigo gets the inbounds pass marked by Wilson. Three-point attempt off the rim, no good. By Heyer, and back comes McEachern with numbers 3-on-2. Blocked from behind by Rodrigo, stays with McEachern.
See, that's what Hillgrove weren't doing in the first half. They weren't being aggressive. Now they're staying aggressive, getting back and contesting all the shots that McEachern tried to put up.
Here's Rodrigo with the block. Third quarter field goal percentages. Hillgrove 4 of 17. McEachern only 1 of 7. Cooper tries a 3. Got it. John, you talk about daggers, and you will all weekend. That was probably one of them to get it back to 15.
I think that was one of them. I think there's a couple more to come if McEachern's going to try to build in this lead, but they cannot slip up and make the necessary fouls, especially away from the basket like Cooper just committed.
Fourth foul on Taya Cooper now. It's a question for Phyllis Arthur. What does she do? One of her point guards. So what does she do? She's going to bring in Montgomery at the next dead ball. Lester dribbling, trying to dribble out of traffic. Rodrigo into the paint. Steed, Ingram, triple teamed, and they got a foul in there. But that's something that you've seen all night long. There's always two or three bodies. As soon as that basketball is still, two to three bodies surround it instantly.
That's right. They swarm to the basketball. They don't have a height advantage, but they got a quickness advantage. So when the ball goes into the post, they want to go in there and dig it out.
First free throw short by Ingram. And you got to think all that tape on that right hand has been bugging her. Here's the numbers for the game right now, 6 points and 2 fouls.
But she's giving it at all. You can see she's there. She's focused. She said, I got to get back. I'm going to defend. I'm going to play tough. Get me some deflections and steals. Do the dirty things, the little things that's going to help my team get a W.
Second free throw up and good. Back to 14 now, 46-32, a minute 10 in. Wilson with the ball in the front court to Mia Cooper. Looping pass inside. That's what happens when you've got 6'5". And a foul over the back trying to get the shot up. Looks like it's going to be on McKenzie Ingram trying to battle Montgomery on the inside.
Now, John, here's the things that I'm going to question Coach Arthur about right here. You got 6 minutes and 43 seconds to go in the game. State championship on the line. Take the defense out of the zone. Spread them out. Force them to get to man-to-man. Now you can make penetrating pack plays and get easy baskets.
Man puts his thinking cap on. That's what he comes out with. We'll see if they follow his advice. Missed free throw, no good. Patches Roberts there for the stick back. And that was big because you miss a free throw, come back with another bucket. It's back out to 16 at 48-32. Minute and a half gone, fourth quarter. Rodrigo driving, hacked at, shot, misses everything, kicks back out, higher looking for the jumper, rims out, no good. Picked up by Montgomery on the inside, or by Patches Roberts on the inside, another foul. Talk about this lead getting to 16. Here's the miss. Look at the position right there by Roberts to get it in.
I tell you what, her presence has been missed. Now she's going to get there, get the two shot opportunities, now get to the free throw line for 1-1.
Ninth team foul on Hillgrove. McEachern has 7. First free throw missed. Gets her own rebound again with the stick back.
Look at that. She's putting herself in a position for Player of the Year. Winning the game last night versus Norcross, she probably would wrap it up for Player of the Year for the state.
And another turnover coming back the other way. Cooper doesn't have numbers, throws it up, easy two for Dominic Wilson.
John, you talked about daggers. I think three or four were just thrown in those last two up and down opportunities between both teams. The daggers that just were received by Hillgrove, I think it's going to hurt a little bit.
It was down to 12. It's now back up to 20, just like that. 2 minutes and 2 seconds in to the fourth quarter, and here's your last bucket.
Attacking in transition, having three around the basket for the tip-in.
McEachern's on a 6-0 run the last 22 seconds. And there's the resume right there, looking for their first ever undefeated season. Their Final Four appearances right there as well. They lost in the finals to Norcross. You saw that flashback. And they have 5A championships as well. So it's McEachern has region championships in 5A. So you have this great pedigree of McEachern, and you see how it's evolved to this particular point. Right now, where they're 32-0, 5:58 away from their first ever state championship.
Well, they came out in the fourth quarter. They knew that the third quarter was a rough one. It was a tough one. Coach Arthur did a good job coaching on the sideline. We've got to win with our pressure. We've got to win with our defense. And that's exactly what they've been doing.
McEachern, fourth quarter from the field, 3 of 4. Hillgrove, 1 for 3. And when you get 20 points in less than a minute, and you get 6 points in less than a minute to get it to a 20-point advantage. Whistles on the inside. That's where we are right now at 52-32. Higher looking to inbound. Having to go deep, thinking about Rodrigo. Steps over the in-line, turnover.
That's the pressure defense that Coach Arthur wants for our program. When they pressure you defensively, force those turnovers, they can extend the lead like they're doing. And now it's a 20-point game.
5:45 in counting regulation. Let's see if Hillgrove has another one of those runs in him. Rodrigo picked off by Montgomery. And they call Ingram for the foul as Wilson tries to go baseline. It will be the 10th team foul for Hillgrove. Dominic Wilson going to the line in the 20-point game.
John, you can look at Hillgrove now. I think they saw that window of opportunity. I think it's shut.
First free throw up, rolls in. Tiffany Schick in the game. Ingram checking out. Wilson averaging 15 points, just under 4 assists on the season. Had 21 last night in the semifinals, 7 of those in the fourth quarter against Norcross. 22-point game, 54-32. Rodrigo looking. Lester trying to drive into the paint. Around the horn, higher with the three. Rimming, no. Picked up by Cooper. Tried to pass to Wilson. Intercepted. Rodrigo falls down in the paint. And we got a whistle.
I love Rodrigo. She is a heart and hustle. All heart and hustle. She's tenacious. She doesn't care. She'll give up her body for the success of her team. She's getting in there. She's been knocked all over the place. She's going to be really good for Wake Forest.
Ten rebounds, 10 assists in last night's semifinal against North Gwinnett for the triple-double, 11-13 from the foul line. We had a lot of the team's points to get them to this particular point. Back to 20 at the 5:20 mark. Wilson going long, Cooper, jumper, rims out, no. Crashing the boards, matches
wow.
Roberts.
The last 4 out of 5 possessions, it's going through Roberts. Rebounding, scoring, defense, she's all over the place. She's going out with a ring.
22-point advantage. Lester tries for 3, misses everything. Heyer tries to get the ball in. Let's take a look at that last bucket.
Well, she's right now contending for Player of the Year in the state. She's all over the place. Look at that. Having the focus and the will to touch it back with a shot, get the deuce, and sprint back on defense.
Jocelyn Ramos checking out, as does Kayla Montgomery. They will sit. So the 5 is Destiny Gibbs back in with her 4 fouls. Patches Roberts, the law firm of Cooper and Cooper and Wilson. Mia Cooper met at half court. by Lester. Traded it off now, Diamond Thomas. Drive, dish, battled for. Patches Roberts comes out with a loose ball from the free throw line. Rims out, no good. Fought for again on the inside with Gibbs. And what's the call here? Calls on Diamond Thomas, the foul for Hillgrove, and that'll send Destiny Gibbs to the line. You figure with Gibbs being a senior, you're up 22. She's going to go out until she gets the fifth or stays the duration.
Tell you what, she's gonna play. The game's not over completely, but you want to finish out strong if you're McEachern. And Gibbs is just a solid player. Going to Ole Miss, she's a great scorer, but she's one of the leaders on this team.
7 points, five rebounds last night in the semifinal against Norcross. Gets the back end of two, 57-34 McEachern. 23-point advantage coming up, a 4.5 to go regulation. Put in the hands of Selena Rodrigo, guarded by Wilson. Diamond Thomas, Schick up high. Ingram in, given two presences. Ingram off the back rim, no good. Picked up by Destiny Gibbs, looking to get out and transition. There it is, Wilson, one touch in the bucket.
Those are the type of plays that number two ranked national teams make. Rebound, board it out, outlet, touch pass, layup.
Halfway home in the fourth quarter for a championship here in 5A between McEachern and Hillgrove in transition. Again, Gibbs tries to reorient her shot, and it gets knocked off. She'll go to the line. Update from Macon, AAA girls, Columbia leading West Side Augusta 37-21. So if that holds, it's going to be the match everyone thought it was going to be, that you and I will be talking about tomorrow. Washington County and Alicia Gray. Mm-hmm. Going up against the Columbia girls, head coach Shantae Frost, and Zuri Frost, the youngest daughter, is the point guard. So it could be an interesting matchup in AAA if that holds true to form.
As we talked about at the beginning of the telecast, this is a great weekend for Georgia basketball. It's March Madness here in the state of Georgia. You got the ACC tournament going on, but I think everyone's very excited about Georgia high school basketball.
We talked about how the game had gotten down to 12. McEachern slammed the door shut on a 14-2 run to make it 60-34 with 3:40. Knocked over to Dominic Wilson for the two.
Dumb coach foul. I'm looking to call a timeout. Don't want this game to get out of control. Just to control it, maybe extend my career just a little bit longer.
Wholesale substitutions. Looks like Coach Fowler is going to empty her bench for Hillgrove at the next dead ball. Diamond Thomas loses control. Cooper and Cooper come up with it. Nice bounce pass. Wilson fouled by Schick at the 3:11 mark.
I think Coach Fowles did a great job of getting those girls here to the state championship. Again, we talked about her career. 30 years in coaching. Her final game of coaching. And I think she's proud of just being here. I think they were just more happy just to be here in this position.
Runner-up in 1984. It was the only other time she was in a championship game. The old Campbell High School, Campbell Smyrna. Home of David Boyd, who coached at Campbell as well. He's going to be seeing coming up next as Milton takes on Savannah in the 5A boys title game. There she goes, emptying out her bench. But Fowler has ties to McEachern. After her 7 years at Campbell, she coached 16 years at McEachern, then went over to Hillgrove to start the Hillgrove program, and it looks like Coach Arthur's doing the same with her bench. And Fowler was actually lured out of retirement to come back and coach her seniors this particular season to get them to where they are today. A lot to be proud of.
And that shows you her love for the game, but her love also for these young girls. They're going to actually treasure her coaching and the things that they shared this entire season for the rest of their lives.
Jump ball situation. Rodrigo on the drive. We're heading back the other way. Lindsay Theory is in a happy bunch of folks. Lindsay, what's the word?
We believe that we are one. We believe that we are one. We believe that we are one.
see how it ends up. It's like jump around. And I just hope that Lindsay Theory is safe and can get out of there in one piece as we get to the 2.5 minute mark. 30-point game. McEachern up 30, 64-34 on Hillgrove.
We believe that we're going to win. Good thing.
They're certainly doing that. Once again, two Final Fours from McEachern, 05 and last year. Changing their luck after the 25-point loss to Diamond DeShields and Norcross last season. First ever championship is 2 minutes and 19 seconds away, and Dominic Wilson takes his seat, as does Destiny Gibbs.
And talking to Coach Arthur yesterday, one of the things she was just so excited about this chance, and she felt good about them winning the championship. And we asked her about National Coach of the Year opportunity. She was more focused on the state championship. She didn't care about the national ranking. But at the same time, you win here, you're going defeated. Your team is going to be in contention for National Team of the Year.
14 points for Selena Rodrigo. Make it 14 still after it goes off the back rim. They get the rebound. Rodrigo for three, no good. Rebound picked up by McEachern. Once again, that transition offense been there all night long. Time to go deep into the playbook. The shot's blocked. Allison Carroll comes up with the ball. Knocked out of bounds with Marissa Lester. Savannah Patrick in for McEachern. But let's run it down. The law firm, the Coopers. And there you see the ninth grader, Taya Cooper, who's going to be around, who's already going to North Carolina. Her sister comes back for her senior year, goes to South Carolina. Dominique Wilson to Arkansas. Patches Roberts to Syracuse. Kayla Montgomery to Clemson. Destiny Gibbs to Ole Miss. Think about where this squad is and what they've been able to do. Is this one of the most stacked squads that you've ever seen or heard of when it comes to this state?
Well, here's the thing, as we talked about this. The state of Georgia has become a recruiting haven for college coaches all over the United States. So there's so much competition. There's so many basketball teams, the AAU teams during the summer. AAU season starts next week. So you think these kids are going to get off right now? No, they're going to start playing AAU basketball. So the visibility that these kids get and they continuously play year-round, that's why these kids are being signed at all these different colleges.
DeClaria Daniels will sit. And this is the emptying of the bench for both squads. Kenya Anderson now in number 12 for Hillgrove, along with Monique Panu. Anderson with the basketball, tosses off the pass to Jaya Smith with the jumper, no good. McEachern comes back with it. Triana Tisdale now running point. Dribble drive up and shot is no good. Rebound fought for Kiwana Patterson. 11 for McEachern, tries for it. Elbow in the paint and a lot of bodies hitting the floor, and they're going to call steps on Panu for Hillgrove with 64 seconds to go in the season. McEachern leading 64-35. Anna Brannon sitting now for Hillgrove, getting some work in. Jump shot up and gets the roll into the scorebook. Quintisha Martin with a three to make it 67-35. With 50 seconds and counting. Tina Thompson loses control of it. Tisdale with the spin in the paint, no good. Picked up. I think they're going to let him play for the last 40 seconds. Jaya Smith, 40 for Hillgrove. One of the players has blown a tire. I think it was, in fact, Smith. Shot, no good. Coming back out with it, McEachern. 25 seconds to go before their first state title whistle. And a foul as Martin tried to drive.
It shows you, Coach Arthur, how she coaches. Even the subs come in the latter part of the bench, they're still applying the same type of pressure, the same type of scheme, shooting the threes. Let's go defend. Let's rebound. Let's outlet. Let's be quick in transition. That's how the entire team plays. That's how they practice.
Kenya Anderson, Tanae Thompson, Monique Panu, Jaya Smith, and Aaliyah Cass in for Hillgrove. Tia Tisdale, Savannah Patrick, Quintisha Martin at the line. Kiwana Patterson in the game. and Salome. Those are your fives right now for the final 22.9. 64-35, McEachern getting their way to their first state title, besting their region rival for the fourth time this year. A battle of Region 4 number 1 versus Region 4 number 2. Foul on the inside, and Selena Rodrigo will go to the line one more time. She's heading to Wake Forest. Meredith Heyer heading to the University of Georgia to play softball. And Maisie Steed is heading to Kentucky to play softball.
Well, they got some athletes there at Hillgrove. A lot of good athletes at Hillgrove.
69-35 McEachern. Rodrigo heading to Winston-Salem after this. First free throw is good. 69-36. Salome will inbound to Triana Tisdale. Say that 10 times fast. Last 10 seconds. Jumper is off. Rebound. It crashed once again. Clock will stop with 4.5 seconds. It'll go to Hillgrove. And that will give McEachern the 5A championship. And that bench is ready to hit the floor.
They are, John. They want to explode. And we talked to Coach Arthur yesterday to get prepared for the tournament. They practice at Kennesaw State, and it's definitely paying off.
Point win for McEachern crowns their season coast to coast number one in Class 5A, 33-0, solidifies at the very least their number two national ranking. Coach Arthur also in consideration for Naismith honors nationally. And you have to say a lot of great things about Coach Arthur and what she's been through, especially after last year's 25-point loss in the finals. And she was more anxious yesterday in the semifinal than she was about the final.
Well, she knew in order to get to tonight's contest, they had to beat Norcross, and you can see she's a very emotional young lady. And, you know, that's how she coaches, and that's good because her team's the same way. They play with emotion, they play with energy, and that's what they want to copy their coach, and they've done a great job, and hats off to McEachern and the success that they've had with this program this year.
And hats off to Cheryl Fowler as well. And Hillgrove, a great career comes to a close. 32 years as a teacher, 30 years as a coach. Runner-up in 84 at Campbell, runner-up again this year for Hillgrove. A great run for the Hawks, finishing their year 26-5. That is going to do it for the early part. When we come back to the arena at Gwinnett Center, it will be Mark Harmon and the trophy presentation. McEachern, your 5A girls champs, 29-point winners over region rival Hillgrove. More from the arena at Gwinnett Center when we return on GPB. Welcome back to the arena. Gwinnett Center Class 5A Girls Championship is in the book. 69-36 McEachern over Hillgrove, a battle of Region 4, Region 1, seed number 1 versus seed number 2 out of Region 4. John Nelson alongside the coach, Sean Golden. And in this game and going back two more games, we've had three games today, we've seen a lot of great basketball, and it says a lot about what goes on in DeKalb County with Southwest DeKalb and Miller Grove and what we've seen in Cobb County with Hillgrove and McEachern.
I tell you what, these two counties, the state of Georgia has a lot of basketball, boys and girls. It's going to get better because the beautiful thing is a lot of these kids are underclassmen.
All right, we're going to send it over to the man who has the best seat in the house, and this time it's a place where only one team can be. Mark Harmon has the trophy presentation.
Thank you, John. First off, congratulations to the McEachern Lady Indians, 33-0, undefeated, number one. Well done. And for the trophy presentation, here is Ernie Yarbrough of the GHSA.
Congratulations to McEachern, and we're pleased to have representatives from Georgia Farm Bureau here to present the awards.
Georgia Farm Bureau family would like to congratulate McEachern on a job well done, and keep up the good work, young ladies. Congratulations, Coach.
All right. Give him that trophy. Coach Phyllis Arthur, go away. Congratulations, Coach. What a season.
Yes.
When it began, did you think it would end this way?
We hoped to. Our goals were to end this way. Those were our goals. So we expected it, and they fulfilled our dream.
How proud of you are of this team?
I am very proud. I love them to death like they're my own children. I am so proud of this group. They have worked hard all season long, and they deserve it.
All right, Patches Roberts, where you are here. Show that megawatt smile right now. You are state champions. How's that feel?
It feels great. I don't know what to say. I mean, I'm excited. It feels great to finally win state after 4 years. Last time playing with the McEachern Indians. I'm going to miss y'all.
You may miss it. Hold that trophy up high. Well, well done. What does this mean to you to be a part of this team?
It means a lot. I mean, we worked hard. We play as a family, and we are a family, and I'm really going to miss these girls.
All right, Coach, one last question. You've got a lot of kids coming back. You've got a lot of seniors taking off now to a lot of impressive universities to play at the next level. You must be just welling up with pride right now.
I'm welling up with pride, and this is bittersweet. It's sweet that we won, and it's bitter that I'm getting ready to lose a great group right here, and I love them to death, and it tears me apart to know they have to go, but I know they got to move on to bigger and better things. And I want to say thank you to our crowd in the stands, McEachern Indians.
It'll be a hot time in Powder Springs tonight, I guarantee it. Congratulations to the McEachern Indians, number one, 33-0, ranked number two in the nation, but I think number one in the nation. And now it's time for our GPB tailgate party to kick off.